Putting your ideas out, you're putting some of your humanity out into the world, and you know, people talk about it. They have opinions about it. It's like personal to you, but they have opinions about it. Collectors don't normally do that, right? I mean, they buy it, they put it in the bedroom, they know they like it, but they don't bring it out in the world and say, what do you think about it? It's risky, and one of the goals of the group is to bridge the relationship between collectors and artists, so that people can understand what goes on for an artist in the world. And so presenting the work, she said, well, I don't know what other people think about it, but this is what I chose. That's a risk. So that was part of this making it public, is engaging collectors in a very public discussion about what they chose.
So a lot of these were from here. And actually, when I go to a show, this is kind of funny, because in the back of my head, you analyze a work of art in a lot of different ways, but I also always, in the back of my head, thinking, is this something that I did or no? So this game was sort of well-suited, I was well-suited to it, but this, it was an interesting combination of, the encaustic, like Salcedo, it has a nice texture, but it's like, it's landscape, it's collage, it's text. In the art, it had a lot of elements to it, but really it was the image, the colors, this idea that the artist did have, just a statement they were making. So that's why this was the second thing I would have bought if I if I was going to. This, I just have a weird love of like Dutch still life painting. I have a piece that my mother had bought, which is fruit and something. It's just like, oh, you can have a friend. So.
I like the title of this one, Ode to Clementine.
Ode to Clementine. Yeah. And this, you know, we've been fortunate in Rochester to be the epicenter of the craft art movement since the 70s. And there's just a lot of really wonderful ceramic work, woodwork, and, but I like this because it really pushed the envelope up by making a vessel, but it's also a sculptural object. You know, I just felt like I would love to have this in like the corner of my dining room and look at it every day, you know? And this is another one. I think it was a few years ago. I'm always drawn to these. It was a laundromat. It was these very colorful chairs in the laundromat. And again, it was like, oh, I could have bought that. So it's like, oh, there it is. I can buy it. I looked up, he had a the hashtag. And it looks like he does take pictures of three chairs when he sees them. But it was funny, a lot of his work wasn't like this, where it's almost abstracted in terms of the forms and the colors, even though knowing you're looking at three chairs. But this, I like this kind of photography where it's very formalistic, if that's the right word. So that was definitely one of the best. What he said. I don't even know what it is about this one. It is just weird enough and spooky enough. And again, the artist is, I guess, the sense the artist is saying something. I don't exactly know what it is, but I'm curious about it. It also, I mean, this is the thing about the image. It's coming off the wall a little bit, which is nice. And that sense that it's coming into my space. Also, from here, just love the color. We have at least one piece by
the way, too.
And every time one of those about things happens, it's so nice to see those colors. Now, the thing is, the works are getting more expensive, that's why they're like lower on the list. But yeah, and then, again, there's not a lot of figural stuff that I'm absolutely drawn to. I bought this in my house, but Rome's current exhibition, his current selections from his collection that are hanging in our home, were images of women. And I just thought, well, this would be great to hang these with all those other pictures for women. And there's something about the fact that it's like, it's not. And it's almost monochrome because the tones are very close, but it's totally not monochrome. So, you know, it spoke as an image, it spoke as a color field. Now this we saw at, this is a group called Free Art.
The Free Art Collective.
The Free Art Collective. And it's a very interesting group. The woman who kind of conceived it and makes it happen with some also very committed people, their mission is to basically get art out for people to have. It's literally free. And she does fundraising for the materials, and she does like Dollar doing the 6x6s she built. She and some other artists affiliated with the group will go out and invite people to make art with them.
She'll be here tomorrow.
Oh, excellent. Okay. A perfect marriage there. Yeah, I just liked the way the colors I have another drawing. It's a pencil, like a very heavy pencil drawing, maybe charcoal, of this kind of very voluptuous woman falling. She's like falling through the image in this very triangular way. And I don't know, there's something about this and that resonated with me. And I'm like, ooh, I'd love to hang these together. And also, I do like the idea of supporting an artist, I'm assuming, who is fairly early in their career. So I could go buy this one, I suppose, but I added it to my list of things I would buy. This one's right over here. Just feathery. And I like the colors. It was soft. I think it would be nice to have in the house. Now, so that was my $2,000 up to that picture. This was, we went to the Shuttleworth Memorial, it's in Auburn. They have a fabric arts show every year, so it's basically quilts. But, and it is unbelievable what these artists do with fabric in this. It's not always in a plane, sometimes they can come out, but. So I set myself the challenge. Well, plus a lot of them were like you could have bought one and that would have been the budget. So this was, I set myself the task of choosing one after I hit my $2,000. And this one just leapt out at me, the colors, the movement, it was hard because a lot of them, just what they do with the fabric to create their image is phenomenal, or what they do with the stitching. Anyway, out of all of them that I could afford, that was the one. Now, interestingly enough, these are works I actually did buy at the small work show at Main Street Arts, which they have in December. And then they're so wiped out that I was thinking, oh, joy, it's in January. I was thinking of you. They take a little hiatus to recover. Again, this was just color, because a lot of things I'm drawn to are sort of earth tone-y, and so I challenge myself every once in a while to get something that has some color. And this is another thing about this that's challenging is you don't get the size. Mm. So like that quilt was like the size of the wall, you know. But the things that's coming up next is like, you know. Like small, well, there's three of them. So this was on the staircase. They have something called the Staircase Gallery at Main Street Arts. And it seems to be prints, but it's smaller works. And they hang and load up the stairs to their second floor library, which is place. And I like these. Again, this idea of a photograph that abstracts something. She goes out and she finds, like, posters that are, I mean, like street, things that are put up on the street and have maybe been, you know, partly taken down or weathered by time and become these things she sees, she selects from the larger field. So this one is, it's called Les Citrons, the lemons, but they were just like, you know, brown, yellow things in whatever the bigger image was. And again, and those, it was just like I couldn't find one. I felt like they had to speak to each other. So like those two just felt like they had to be together. So those are ones I actually bought.
So Elizabeth used $7,870 out of her budget, and she had an average of $414. Did you, when you look back and talk about the amount you spent?
But it was like that we didn't go till this week, and I had already done all my priorities, went through 10 a.m., but I just didn't do it.